My respected elders and brothers, you all know, I don't have to tell you, that all over the world, Muslims are going through a tough phase. And all over the world, it's not in Pakistan or Australia, everywhere, Muslim is having a tough time. Musa alayhi salam asked once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, you have given me such a ummat that for 40 years you sent the sustenance from the Jannat to my ummat for 40 years without doing any work. They were born with clothes and their clothes and a shade under the sun used to walk with them when he used to walk for 40 years. And Allah showed them so many miracles. So Musa asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh my Allah, is there any ummat better than my ummat? Allah replied, oh Musa, yes, there is a ummat of Nabi alayhi salatu salam, whose virtue over the other ummas are like my virtue on the entire creation. Such a ummat, me and you. And look what is happening today. Punishments and punishment, tribulants and tribulants, worries and worries, diseases and diseases, jails full, hospitals full, all over the world. What is the reason, my brothers? We have to think about it. What is the reason behind it? We are praying, you know, 5 times salat has the power to attract risk sustenance. And we are praying 5 times salat, our risk going to China, Dubai, from Pakistan to Australia, from Australia to USA, risk is going away. Salah has the power to attract the sustenance. But what is happening with my salah? Why if I take a Panadol, my headache is gone after 10 minutes, but salah, I do salah, but my eyes are, my gaze are not lowering when I see a woman. Why? The medicine of a non-Muslim is effective, but the medicine of Allah, in Quran Allah says, that what salah does? It keeps you away from, you know, sins. But we're doing salah, and as the moment we go out of the masjid, woman pass by, we cannot lower our gaze. We are fasting in Ramadan. Ramadan fasting, Allah says, I have given you fasting, Ramadan. So it will bring taqwa in you, taqwa in you. But we are fasting, taqwa is going out instead of coming in. Taqwa is fear of Allah. We, instead of getting fear of Allah, we are getting fear of worldly things. So it's not me, man. It's about the whole Muslim world. We have to think about it. What is happening to us? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, to the nearest meaning, that whatever has happened to Bani Israel, it will happen with my nation as well. Whatever has happened to Bani Israel. And if a Bani Israel young man has committed adultery with his mother, my ummati will do as well. And Bani Israel will kill and mesmerize, my ummati will have the same thing. And you know, the books have written, we have read as well, we have heard as well, that Allah is Habib and Tabib as well, Allah is a doctor as well. When somebody is sick, you know, you take a child to a doctor, he will give first sugar-coated tablet, you know, sugar-coated. Then if it doesn't cure, what will happen? He will give bitter tablet, antibiotics. Then the third phase is injection, fourth phase is minor operation, and fifth phase is major operation. So whatever has happened to Bani Israel, if you look in the books, we are only in the phase of sugar-coated tablets, man. If we don't repent, if we don't come back, what Allah wants from us, the next is, you know, bitter tablets, antibiotics, then injections, then minor operations, and after death, major operations. So what is why Allah is doing is this? Why Allah is doing all this? Because لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ, Allah wants us to follow Allah. Allah wants us to get connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, you all know, I've played 15 years of cricket from Pakistan cricket team. And I have had a deep dive in the dunyavi, you know, all the dunyavi things. I've dived all the way inside, you know. And I had hundreds of friends. I was just a small, you know, a player. I've seen hundreds of celebrities, you know, rich and famous. And everybody, you know, I met a cricketer from New Zealand just now, a month back. He's very good looking, very tall. We had a long chat. We were chatting about what he's doing, what am I doing. Then he said, "Saeed, what are you doing? What are you up to, mate?" I said, "Well, I'm nothing up to. I'm just trying to, you know, rectify my things, you know." And I told him about my life. He said, "Yes, I'm making money. I've made this. I said, "Hey, hold. Okay, you have made the outwardly thing. Tell me what is inside. How is inside?" He said, "This is pretty bad. Don't ask about it. Sleepless nights. No satisfaction. Full of fear. No peace." And when I was talking to him about Islam, now he starts, he goes there on. "Hey, hold. Are no Muslims more than you, man? What can we say? We cannot give da'wah to them." Because they're saying, "Man, all the calamities from the skies are coming to Muslims. The earthquakes, Muslim fight." Allah in Quran has three punishments for us. Wrong time of rainfalls, pelting of stones from the skies, earthquakes, cyclones, and Muslims fighting each other. Allah will make us fight, you know. Nobody dare can make Muslim fight, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not a leaf of a tree can fall itself without the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can anybody kill us, man? But you know, you've seen a football. Football is kicked all over the world. You know why a football is kicked all over the world? Because football is beautiful from the outside. A FIFA sticker on top, a Nike sticker on top. Inside is empty. Muslims now trying to make the outer world beautiful. Iman, amal, khalas, finish. Now being kicked all over the world. Like a football. They cannot kick a brick, you know. You kick a brick, heavy cement brick, you will break your leg. But today you see, Iman, Amal, finish. Only five times Salah, quick Salah. Abdurrahman bin Auf was a big businessman. Somebody knocked at the door. "Hey Abdurrahman, who is it?" "I'm a businessman. Wanted to have trade with Abdurrahman." "He's gone to the masjid. When will he get back?" "No, we don't know when will he come back. If somebody comes at my door, hey Saeed Anwar, he's gone in the masjid. When will he come back?" "In 2 minutes he'll come back. He doesn't like masjid. 2 minutes for Salah, finish, khalas." Say, "Don't. And if I'm in a business, we don't know when Saeed will come back. He might go to Dubai, to USA. For business, he doesn't come back." My respected elders, mashallah, you guys are so talented. You've got all the talent, you know. Allah has put talent in us. What talent Allah put in Ambiyas, you know. That's why we are the chosen one. We've been chosen to do this work.